channel. Today we will be doing a spring editorial makeup look, and this look was inspired by a picture that I saw on Instagram, and I also drew it out on my face chart.
Now, these face charts,
and with the help of someone on YouTube, I used monkey pick or pick monkey, where I put my makeup name at the bottom or wherever on the page that you want to put them, but I put them at the bottom. So yeah, I drew it out. This was like probably my third look. I'm still learning how to do face charts, and it's pretty fun once you get the hang of it. I already moisturized my face. I washed it with my Dr. Murad acne kit, and I moisturized my face with my rose petals oil for hydration. First, I will be starting off my brows with my Anastasia Dip Brow Pomade in dark brown. And I'm just going to fill my eyebrows in a little bit. I'm looking down into my mirror. I already filled in my eyebrows, and I used the Anastasia Beverly Hills Concealer in 3.75 for cleaning up my eyebrows, and I'm just using this brush from BH Cosmetics to brush it out and smooth out the concealer around my eyebrows. Now I'm using the MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pot to use as a primer for my eyeshadows. And I'm just smoothing it out to make an even base for my eyeshadows. Now, what I should have done was set it with my Laura Mercier powder to make a smooth surface for my eyeshadows. I didn't do it, but I guess I'll do it next time. Now I'm using the yellow chrome eyeshadow from MAC, and I'm going to take another brush here from BH Cosmetics, and then I'm going to put that in the crease. I'm going to start off from the crease and just fluff it out. What I also should have used was a flatter brush for my lids. I don't know why, but I just mainly use this brush for the whole entire look. Because we were only using yellow, so I mean, I didn't. Next time I'll just do it, but yeah. So I start off with the crease, and I'm just gonna go around the eyes with this color. And I'm sorry, I need to get a better angle or put my mirror in a better place, because I'm like always in the corner. My mirror is right there, so that's why I keep looking down. But I'm just buffing in that color, adding more wherever I need to. And now I'm taking my mascara from Too Faced. This is their Better Than Sex mascara, not the waterproof one, the pink one. And I'm just adding some mascara on my teeny tiny eyelashes, preparing for my falsies that I'll be using in a couple of seconds. And here I'm putting my eyelashes on. These eyelashes are wispies. These are from Shop Miss A, I believe. They're like $1 a pair. And they're just pretty small wispies. I like them. I am so horrible. I have no patience when it comes to my lashes. So every time I put them on, well, most of the times that I put them on, I cannot wait for the glue to get tacky, and I need to learn to be patient. But here I'm just reapplying that yellow eyeshadow, and wherever it seems to be a little creasy, I just add a little bit more shadow and just buffing around and smoothing the edges around all my eyes. To make it nice and vibrant, and just shaping my shadow, make sure you bring it to the temple, to your temples. So here I'm taking my Benefit Professionals primer and I'm gonna apply it all over my face. And I use this about 3 times and it seems to be okay. And then I'm going to mix these two. This is the NYX Gleam and the MAC Jobin Cream. And I'm going to take a little bit and mix the two and apply it wherever you will put your highlighter. So the highest point of the cheekbones, on the chin, the nose, the bridge of the nose, the cupid's bow, and my forehead. And I'm just going to work that in and then blend it out with my IT Cosmetics brush. This is my first time doing this little technique, so I wanted to have a little glow underneath my foundation. I probably should have mixed it with the foundation, but the foundation that you will see that I will be using today, it's in a small compact form, so I couldn't really mix it. Maybe I could have, but I just didn't. So I'm just working that little mixture with in my face just to get a little glow going on. And here's the IT Cosmetics. This brush here, guys, I actually got it from my mom. She ordered it from QVC. She's not a makeup person, but obviously I am. So I would use and see what she ordered from QVC to see if I can use it. And this is the foundation that I was talking about. This is the Bobbi Brown. It's in Almond, number 7. Their stick foundation, but it's in like a little compact square thing. So I literally had to like dig it out because it's a cream foundation and I don't have any brushes that can pick it up properly. So I'll just have to like use the tip of the end of the brush to make a little dig and just spread it over my face with my finger for now. And then I'm going to use the Bobbi Brown Tinted Moisturizer in Dark Tint. And just a dab of that and mix it with the foundation that I have. And I'm just still spreading it around to get an even coat all over my face. Working it in. And this is the tinted moisturizer I was saying, Dark Tint from Bobbi Brown, also SPF 15. And just a small dab, like I said. I'm just gonna put that in the middle of my face and work it outwards. And I'm gonna work with that same IT Cosmetics brush and buff it into my skin. I'm spraying it with the LA Girl Finish and Set and Spray. This is like literally almost done, so I'm just finishing it off. And it actually finished before this tutorial. So this is the last of my LA Girl spray. So RIP to that. It was good while it lasted. So I'm just working that foundation in. Now I'm gonna take this corrector from Bobbi Brown, also in Dark Bisque. And it is, did I say concealer? It's a corrector. Like a light peach corrector. And being that I did my eyes already and I had brought down the yellow
down in my lower lash line, I would have to work around the shadow. So it's like a somewhat reverse concealing, correcting kind of thing. But yeah, so I'm just gonna have to work around the bottom of my shadow, and I'll just blend it out.
Here I'm going into my NYX medium color correcting and concealer palette, and I'm just gonna mix two colors together to make a concealer to go underneath my eyes and over the Bobbi Brown correcting that I just used. And I'm gonna bring this on my nose, my forehead, Cupid's bow, and my chin area. I'm then going to blend that out with my It's Cosmetics brush again. And I am just blending it out to make it seamless. And then I will be going in with my Laura Mercier setting powder to set wherever I concealed. And I'll be using a beauty sponge to do so. So I'm just setting the concealer. Set it and forget it. Remember that? The infomercials. So my chin, my nose, and my forehead. Here I will be setting the rest of my face with my Studio Fix in NW45, the powder from MAC. And I'm just buffing that in, setting the rest of my face where I did not highlight and conceal. So set, 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 powder, 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 puff, puff, puff. My head tie is coming off. Do you know how many times I had to retie my head tie in this video? And then I'm gonna go in with the MAC Give Me Sun for a little more bronzier look. Set, 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 powder, 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 puff, puff, puff. Now here I am using the tip of my brush to break up whatever little clumps of blush I have left in my palette. You can see it's broken up. This is my Tarte Doll Face or Dollhouse blush, which I certainly still love and still use. It's still there. There's still product, and I will use this until there's nowhere left. So that's what I was doing earlier, just chunking it up and breaking it into, just to make it more dustier. But yeah, that's what I use on my face as blush. So I'm just applying that on my cheeks, on the apple of my cheeks. I love this blush. I love Tarte blushes. Oh, like, it's God. They're so pigmented. In my video.
And I just love them. Oh yeah, that was my sister in the background. If you guys were asking yourselves if you saw something or someone move. Yeah. So I'm just blending that in and bringing it up. Here I'm going in with the highlighter part of my Sleek Medium Highlight and Contour palette. I'm just using the highlighter part, and I'm going to use my Anastasia Beverly Hills highlighting brush, A23 brush. And I dipped it in the highlighter first, and then I sprayed the brush with the LA Girl spray just to make it come up a little more glowy. Now this is a subtle highlight. It's nothing crazy or anything like that. I was just trying to make it subtle because I didn't want to be glowing as much because the eyes were already so bright and bold. So yeah, I kept it really subtle with the highlight somewhat for now, and then I topped that with my champagne pop from Becca, of course. I love that highlight, like, oh my goodness, I love it. I love it, I love it, I love it. And like I said earlier, Becca's champagne pop. So I'm just gonna take a little bit of it and just put it, yes, right on the center of my highest cheekbone, the highest point of my cheekbone. And you could see it. I mean, I wish I got a better camera, but I have to do this on my iPhone 6 Plus for now. And I was trying to catch what little of natural light was showing through my window because it seemed a little gloomy. The sun was going in and out. So, but yeah, you can kind of see it. And then for my lips, I'm lining my lips with this somewhat brownish, champagne-ish lip liner from L'Oreal. It's actually one of their nudes lip liners. So I'm sorry if I'm out of focus, but I'm looking in my mirror applying the lip liner. So I'm just applying the lip liner here, and I'm just feathering it out and blending it on my lips. For lipstick, we will be using MAC's Sweet and Sour lipstick, and I love this shade. It's so pretty. I'm just applying it on my lips and making sure that I'm blending it out. I probably should have put a little foundation or concealer to blank my lips out a little bit, just to make it a blank canvas. But yeah, so just blending out my lips with the lip liner and reapplying the lip liner if needed. And just contouring it in and shading the corners of my lips to make it a little dimensional. So now here I'm just touching up whatever needs to be fixed and touched up. I'm adding a little bit more highlighter. I touched up on the eyeshadow. I'm then going to spray my face. Earlier I did say that the LA Girl concealer, the LA Girl setting spray was finishing, and it finished before this makeup look was done. So I'm looking for my 6 Plus spray, and this is where I am. I'm drenching my face and I'm just gonna fan it out. And this completes the look.